Good morning, students, and welcome back to the e-learning classes provided by St. Michael's Academy. So, in this video, I am going to continue the chapter 6 of class 4 MS Word formatting from the second topic. And the second topic is paragraph formatting. So, in MS Word, you can also apply some formatting to the paragraph to make it more interesting. So, in paragraph formatting, our first topic is alignment. So, first of all, we should know what is alignment. So, alignment means placing or positioning the content in a page. So, when we place the content in a page, it's called alignment. So, there are four types of alignment. So, let's see the four types of alignment. So, first one is left alignment. So, the left alignment is when the text is aligned with the left margin. So, the left alignment is when the text is aligned with the left margin. So, left margin. So, when the text is aligned with the left margin is called the left alignment. So, in MS Word, this is the default margin. So, this is the default alignment of the text in MS Word. So, in MS Word, the left alignment is the default alignment in MS Word. So, you can also apply the left alignment while going to the home tab in paragraph group. You will see the alignments, the left alignment, the centered alignment, the right alignment and the justified alignment. Then you have to go and click to the alignment to set the alignment in MS Word, or else you can also press the short key for the left alignment is CTRL+L. So you can also go to the paragraph group and choose the alignment, or else you can press the short key to set the alignment in MS Word. For left alignment is CTRL+L. It is the short key to the left alignment. Now second, centered alignment. So the centered alignment is when the text is in the center of the left and right margin. So when the text is placed to the center, to the both left and right margin is called the centered alignment. So centered alignment is look like this centered alignment. So this is called the centered alignment when the text is placed in the center of the left and right margin. And the short key to select the centered margin is CTRL+E. So the short key for the centered alignment is CTRL+E. Now third one is right alignment. So the right alignment is when the text is aligned with the right margin. So the right alignment is when the text is aligned with the right margin. So the right margin is from the right side, from the right side, right margin. And the short key to select the right margin in MS Word is CTRL+R. And the short key to select the right margin, the right alignment is CTRL+R. The short key to the right alignment is CTRL+R. Now fourth one, justified alignment. So this alignment is when the text is aligned with the both left and right margin. So justified alignment is when the text is aligned with the both left and right margin. So the short key to the justified alignment is CTRL+J. CTRL+J. So and the justified alignment is looks like this in paragraph group. You can see the justified alignment like this, and you can select from that paragraph group, or you can go to the short key CTRL+J to select the justified alignment in MS Word. So now we will see the next topic under paragraph formatting is indentation. So first of all, we should know what is indentation. So you see the blank space on each side of the paragraph in MS Word. So when you move paragraphs from the left side, right side, or both sides from the margin, so when you move the paragraph from both side or left side or right side indivisibly. So this is called the indentation. So there are two types of indentation: left indentation and right indentation. So let's see how we can move the paragraph from the left indentation, from the left side of the margin. So step one, click anywhere in the paragraph you want to indent from the left. So when you want to indent the paragraph from the left side, you have to click anywhere you want to indent from the left. Step 2, then click increase indented button. So you have to click on increase indented button, or you can also press the short key CTRL+M to indent the paragraph from the left side. So when you indent the paragraph from the left side, or you want to remove the left indented or in the paragraph, so you can click on decrease indented button, or you can also press the short key CTRL+M. So you can press the short key CTRL+Shift+M to remove the left indented. So to remove the left indented by clicking decrease indented, or you can press the short key CTRL+Shift+M to remove the left indented. So now we will see the right indentation in paragraph. So step one, we have to click the page layout tab. So first of all, we have to click on the page layout tab. Now step two, under intent group. So when you click on the page layout tab, so you see the intent group. So under intent group, you have to click the increase right indented spinner. So you have to click the right indented spinner to increase or decrease the right indented. Or you can also do the left indented from here also. In the intent group under the page layout tab, you can also increase or decrease the left indented as well as the right indented in the paragraph. So now we will see the next topic under the paragraph formatting is numbering and bullets. So a list helps you to organize the text and helps you to create the point wise text content. So when you click on the bullet and numbering icon, so it becomes activated and each new line begins with the bullet and number. So let's see these steps how you can add the bullet or number in the content. And the bullet and numbering button is available under the home tab. Home tab, you will see the bullet button and the numbering button. So let's see the steps how we can add the numbers or the bullet points in the content. So step one, we have to select the list of text which you want to show as a bullet list or the numbered list. So you have to first select the text which you want to show as the bulleted list or the numbered list. Now step 2, you have to click the small arrow button on the bullet list or the number list to display the bullet list or the number list to show the list of that bullet or the number. So step 3, click any of the bullet type of your choice. So when you select the text and then you have to click on the small arrow on the bullet button to display the list of the bullet, and you have to click any of the bullet style to add the style to your content. So similarly, you can also add the numbers in the same following steps to display or to add the number in the content. So you can add both bullet or the numbers at same following steps. You can go, you have to select the first, you have to select the text and you have to click on the small arrow on the numbered button. So here you clicking a small arrow on the bullet button. So when you have to add number in the content, so you have to click on the small arrow of the numbered button. So the displays the numbered list. So you have to select the choice of your number style to add a number list to your content. And this step, following this step, you can add both bullet or the numbered list to your content. So now we will see the third topic is page formatting. And under the page formatting, the first is changing the page color. So how we can change the page color in MS Word? So let's see the steps how we can change the page color of MS Word. So first of all, step one, we have to click on the page layout tab. So when you want to change the page color, you have to click on the page layout tab. Now step two, under the page background group, you have to click the page color button. So when you want to change the page color, you have to click on the page layout tab, and then you have to go to the page background group, and there you have to click on the page color button. So a menu, or say three, a menu of color will appear in front of you. So you have to move your mouse on the color. So when you move your mouse on the color, the page color change gets changing according to the color when you move your mouse on the color list. So you have to click of the color of your choice to make the page color appear in that color. So now we will see the next topic under the page formatting is adding border to the page. So let's see how we can add border to the page in MS Word. So step one, we have to click the page layout tab. So first of all, we have to click on the page layout tab. In step two, under the page background group. So under the page background group, you see the page border button. So you have to click on the page border button to add the border in the page. So as soon as you click on the page border button, so a dialog box is displayed in front of you, and it shows the list of the border settings, styles and options. So you can apply the border to the whole page in the document or to the just one page or the front page of the document. So you can add border to your choice. So you can add border to the whole document or to the one page only, or you can add border to the front page of the document. Now step 3, you can set a line of different style with width and color as the border. Page border, as you can set as page border. So you can set the line of the different styles with width and the color as the page border. So you can choose the different style as width and the color as the page border. You can set as page border. You can also use the pictures or arts as the page border in MS Word. So you can also add some pictures or arts as the page border in the document. So you can add to the whole document or to the one page or to the front page only you can add the border in a page. So following these steps, you can add a border to the page in MS Word. In this way, we have finished the chapter 6, MS Word formatting. So I hope you all had understood the topics. So revise this chapter, and I will be solving the exercise of this chapter in next video. So stay tuned for the next video. Thank you so much.